I've got an itch I can't scratch. I'm missing a piece that completes a whole part of me. An open wound scar to see. Everybody come here, gather round. Welcome to the freak show, the best in town. What the hell's wrong with me? I don't get along with anybody, honestly. I've been living in my own head constantly. Thoughts jumbled round, think I need a new lobotomy. Wait, all these thoughts are too negative. I don't wanna get lost in the sedative. Gotta show them what I got, I'm competitive. You know I'm about to go off, I won't let them win. I'll take a stab, I wanna chase a bag. I want a way I can change all the things I lack. I gotta face the facts, I got a taste in that. Got me obsessed with the rest, I got an itch to scratch.
Hi. Wise ba magpatayo ng bahay agad? Or how will you know if it's the right time to buy or build a house? Well, today I'm gonna discuss something na nasa perception ko, idea ko. Hashtag OFW friends. Working like 5, 10, or even 20 years working abroad. It's sad. And trust it, a lot of them, they're asking, bakit di maka-uwi-uwi sa Pilipinas? And then I ask them, saan ba napupunta yung pinaghirapang pera? Hard-earned money working abroad. Sabi nila, usually, papadala sa Pilipinas. Patayo ng bahay, pambili ng kotse, but at the end of the day, hindi naman sila yung nakatira. Hindi rin sila yung nagmamaneho ng kotse. So, in that way, I'm gonna share you some tips and idea about this one. Meron tayong tinatawag na dalawang klase, that ang tawag dito is financial statement of the poor and financial statement of the rich. Paano daw naghihirap ang tao or financial statement of the poor ang ginagawa niya? Yeah, it is a financial statement of the poor if you focus on having a big income, not building asset. Doon daw naghihirap ang tao kapag ang focus niya is mag-earn ng pera at single source of income ang meron siya. Or ang tawag natin doon is active income. Ibig sabihin, we have to work. Kailangan natin magtrabaho. You have to work every day for you to earn. If we don't work, you won't have income. Right? Pag hindi ka nagtrabaho, wala kang income. Kaya, most of our OFW friends na natulungan na natin dito, you know what? They realize na if they stop working, income stop. Ibig sabihin, pag wala na tayo sa abroad, wala na yung dating income. Kaya, ang tendency, pag uwi sa Pilipinas, they get to have a life na kung ano yung life nila before. But, okay, meron sila magandang bahay, magagandang kotse. Kasi, what they did is not business. What they did is employment. Guys, there's nothing against employment. It's okay, you are employed. But, I'm telling you this right now na you have to build asset. Ano yung asset? These are the money-making machine. Ito yung pag sinabing asset, ikaw yung may-ari. Pag mamayari mo. At ito yung pag hulugan mo ng pera, tutubo siya ng pera. So, guys, it's not okay na puro na lang tayo work. Kasi, yun, I know na negosyo naman talaga ang solution. And one big thing is, after you work on how many years, like 5, 10, doing your business, no, magre-rest ka na lang. At pag nagre-rest ka, nagpapahinga ka, kapag asset ang binibuild mo, asset ang ginagawa mo, time will come. you're not working anymore. But money still comes in. Dapat meron kang exit plan. Dapat meron kang plan on how, when and how, kailan ka magre-retire young, free and rich. By the way, my name is Chanel Suliano and I am an online entrepreneur. I use this blog to show you paano ba gawin yung business gamit yung social media. And the last word, 1 million question is, would you like to be an OFW forever? And that's the real deal. See you to my next vlog.